So, could folk hear that?
Just coming through now.
No, we couldn't hear the music.
That's a bit weird.
Have you ticked the music bit on your computer?
On PowerPoint?
No, on the sharing.
On the sharing. Excuse this debate, everybody. Where's that, Matthew?
On the screen share. And then there at the bottom there's play there. Video sound or something like that.
Video sound. I had, right. Sorry, folks. Here's take two. Be spotlighted? Lovely, thank you. Welcome everyone to our Ascension Day service. Alleluia! Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. We're now going to pass over for the first hymn, hymn 445.
Thank you.
readings taken from Luke's Gospel, chapter 24, beginning to read at the 44th verse. Then Jesus said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it was written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. And see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out as far as Bethany and lifted up his hands and he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven. And they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and they were continually in the temple, blessing God.
Thank you, Tim. Ascension Day. And I say it every year. We could do with it being moved to a Sunday, really. It's actually a very important festival for us.
It's the end of Jesus's Easter appearances, when he showed to his disciples and to the followers who were further out on the outskirts of the disciples that he was alive. He met with them physically. He spoke with them. He prayed with them. He offered them peace. He shared meals with them. He spent time with them, showing that he was definitely alive, that he was not a ghost, but a real living person, back from the grave, risen from the tomb. And we've been celebrating that, believe it or not, for 40 days. And today is Ascension Day. What does Ascension Day do for us today? Most of us, when we're offered something, we'll ask that question, don't we? What's it going to do for me? So what does Ascension Day do for me or for you? Well, firstly, it goes a long way to proving that Jesus is still alive, because many there witnessed him taken up alive into heaven. He didn't point to something in the sky and then run off while they were looking the wrong way. It wasn't a conspiracy where he said, "I'm going to retire now. You have to take over." And he waddled off into the desert to become a hermit. Jesus is still alive. And that's actually very important for us as Christians. Important because it gives us hope of eternal life as Jesus calls us to follow him. But it also encourages us to know that he is still there. He is still here. He is still around. That's the heart of the Christian faith. That's why the nickname Christian was invented. Because the followers of the way, as it used to be known, were obsessed with this Christ person who was still alive, and yet no one could physically see him. Yet he had a massive impact on their lives. And we follow on, not just in that tradition, but in that faith that Jesus is still alive, just as he was when those disciples saw him taken up into heaven. Ascension is really part of the fulfillment of the prophets. And Jesus pointed that out to his disciples before he ascended. reminding them that all that he had done was in fulfillment of what God had set out to do. He was part of God's plan, the plan to make a difference for all of us. So Ascension Day also means something for us in the sense that it is God's plan for me and for you. Jesus fulfilling what God wanted to achieve. A new covenant, a new way of doing things. And the Ascension shows that, because Jesus is now with God the Father. And we can talk directly to him. We no longer have to rely on priests, rituals, doing things the right way. Everything we have is based on Jesus, who he is, and where he is now, at the Father's right hand. Jesus, of course, was fully human and fully God. And it means that God's right hand has someone there who understands what it is to be human. Jesus had to live, had to work, had to walk in the heat of the day, had to find food, shelter, had to deal with grief, with pain, injustice. He was a refugee as a child. He was persecuted for standing up for what he knew to be right. That Jesus is with God the Father. So when we bring our prayers to him, we know that he understands and that he will make sure that God understands. That means we can pray with confidence. If we had to rely on some other third party in between, things might get a bit garbled. But we can go directly to God, confident that he will hear and understand. And that's amazing, isn't it? The eternal, infinite God can understand you and me. So the Ascension means that God is no longer remote and distant. He's approachable. He's opened the way for us to become his friends again. Ascension Day is the culmination of so much, and it does so much for each of us. In a moment, we're going to sing a song which highlights some of those things. It talks of the Lord of love. It reminds us of the cross, the freedom that we have through what Jesus has done for each of us. And it reminds us that he is King, because he ascended not just to a place, but to a throne. Our friend Jesus is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And that's worth celebrating. Let us pray. Father God, you sent Jesus on a mission. A mission which he fulfilled. The climax of which we see with the Ascension, when he went back to be with you. We thank you that through him, the Son of Man, fully human, you can understand our cries and our prayers. We thank you that through him, the Son of God, we have a friend who is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Help us never to take these things for granted. And as we seek to live by faith in you, may your ascension, your kingship, your lordship be at the center of our lives. We ask this in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen. Now, I'm going to ask Elizabeth to play the tune for us, the full verse, rather than just a couple of lines to introduce it. And as we sing through, you'll see the verses, how they pick out the bits of Jesus' ministry. And as we sing the words and as you see them, really let them soak in before we move on to a time of prayer together. Elizabeth said to me in the week that she'd been practicing her vigour with that tune. Thank you, Elizabeth. You were one tune too early, but thank you anyway.
I was one what? Too early?
Tune too early. You missed the second hymn. So we'll do that one again in a minute.
I think it might have been me.
Colin.
We'll come to Christ Triumphant at the end.
I thought you'd turn me four just before the service, so I cut one out.
Yeah. But anyway, it doesn't matter. We'll come back to that at the end.
I might get it right next time.
Well, the tune was fantastic, so we enjoyed that. Right, well, let's pray. And as we pray, in our mind's eye, I want you to picture Jesus, very real, very alive, being lifted up in front of you. Perhaps you get a glimpse of his wounds, the scars on his wrists, as he's lifted up into the cloud, as he goes up to be with his Father, the culmination of his work on earth, the fulfillment of all the scriptures, of all that God the Father asked of him. And as you picture that, think, that is my friend who hears my prayers, who understands my yearnings, my concerns, my needs, who is eternal and infinite, who can do all things, and who loves me so much that he went to the cross. Heavenly Father, thank you for sending Jesus. Lord Jesus, thank you for being willing to go to the cross for me, for each of us. We thank you for the Holy Spirit, who enables us to communicate with you directly. Lord, ascension gives us many precious gifts that we don't always understand or fully appreciate. This evening, Lord, we celebrate Jesus our Lord, your great love for us, the new life that you give to those who follow you, your kingship as Lord of Lords and King of Kings. By your Spirit, stir our faith. Enrich us as we follow your way. Guide us as we seek to follow your steps. Be with us in all that we face. Lord, hear our prayers now through and for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And we say together the familiar words that he taught us as we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now, we're going to have a go at Christ Triumphant. I think we all know the tune. Elizabeth, there should be five verses. I apologize for any confusion earlier. So we're going to sing together, Christ Triumphant, yours the glory and the crown. That's who our friend is. And that's amazing.
Are you having five more or one more?
Five verses, yeah.
Right. Do you want an introduction?
Yeah, go on then.
Just a chord?
Just a chord, yeah. Thank you. Let us pray. May the Lord Jesus, born, alive, crucified, buried, risen, and now ascended, bless us and watch over us. May he make his face shine upon us and be gracious to us. May he look kindly on us and give us peace. And the blessing of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be with us and remain with us always. And the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Thank you, Colin, for that lovely picture. I'm not sure where you got that from, but it's lovely. Thank you.